Hi guys, welcome back to Wildebeard Reviews. Tonight we're talking about Star Trek Deep Space Nine, Too Long a Sacrifice, issue 1 of 4, a new Deep Space Nine miniseries from IDW, written by Scott Tipton and David Tipton with art by Greg Scott. Now, I usually don't follow the Star Trek comic books, but in a video the other day, just in passing, I mentioned that Deep Space Nine is my absolute favorite, by a long shot, series of Star Trek, and someone in the comments said, I believe his name was Cam, said, hey, there was a Star Trek Deep Space Nine miniseries that just started the previous week, and I really enjoyed the first issue, so you should go pick it up. And you know what? This past Wednesday, when I was at my shop, I obviously picked it up, and I gotta say, it was a really good first issue. So, like I said, I've never really read Star Trek comics. This is the first one, I believe, that I have ever read, so it really just feels like a part of an episode, and a really good episode at that. So, as you might be able to tell from the photo cover here, this is an Odo-centric story. Something happens on the station, and he has to do the investigator thing. So he's going around gathering evidence, talking to different members of the crew as they go about their daily duties, trying to get all of the information that they're responsible for to him. Of course, he deals with Quark, because something, anytime something happens on the station and it's a little maybe illegal, then Quark is obviously involved. So all in all, it feels like a really solid piece of an episode of Star Trek Deep Space Nine. I say a piece because it's part 1 of 4, so we've only seen like up to maybe the first commercial break or two if we're kind of equating this to an actual episode. So if you are a fan of Star Trek Deep Space Nine, I would recommend you head over to your LCS and pick this one up. Check out issue 1, and then if you like it, put it on your pull list so you can get issues 2, 3, and 4. I know I will be. So with all the kind of non-spoiler stuff out of the way, let's go ahead and dive into the issue, and we can start talking about the details of this book. So it doesn't actually give a timeline as to when during the show this takes place. I don't think it did. Anyway, I tried to look over here, and I don't see anything in the kind of fine print over here, but you can just kind of tell by the way the art is and the character design. The characters already have changed from their earlier uniforms to the uniforms that have the gray on the shoulders. Garak is a main character. They're in the middle of the Dominion War. Worf is there, and it's still Jadzia Dax, so it's still sometime before, I'd say sometime between like seasons 5 and 6 or something like that, right? So we open it up here with a pretty classic Star Trek Deep Space Nine scene with Bashir and Garak meeting for lunch. And guys, I love me some Garak. And so Garak apologizes for being late, and then they go into a restaurant here. They go to this little place called Lavin's Eatery, and Lavin kind of admonishes them because she only ever sees them eating over at the Replimat versus coming into her restaurant. Garak asks Bashir about how things are going with the war, and Bashir's obviously like, oh, I can't tell you anything, Garak, although if I was a betting man, I would say Garak already knows everything that he needs to know about what's going on with the war, because he is, of course, Garak. And so as they're sitting there eating lunch, there's something, a little device here that goes beep, and that alerts Garak, and he jumps and grabs Bashir, and we can see that it was an explosion. You can see him grabbing him right here, pulling him out of the way. And so someone bombs this restaurant on the promenade on the station. So this is, of course, the incident that Odo is going to have to investigate. We get our crew here doing what the crew does. We got Bashir and we got O'Brien and Dax. They're helping out Odo, doing, you know, system sweeps and looking for evidence, pieces of the bomb, and everything like that. So just like I said, good care. Like, this feels like it could have just been like made from a script for Star Trek Deep Space Nine. None of these characters feel out of character for what they were, for what they do in the show. Even you got like investigator notes here from Odo, like he's doing a log, and it says incident occurred on stardate yada yada yada, station time at dining establishment Lavin's Eatery, a restaurant that has been in operation for several years aboard Deep Space or aboard DS9. No history of trouble or violence aside from occasional squabbles with customers. Certainly nothing that would warrant this kind of violence. We got Odo talking to Sisko, giving him an update on everything, and then they go to actually talk to Lavin, the owner and proprietor of the restaurant, and she was in the kitchen, so she was just kind of hurt and in shock about everything. They ask her if she knows anything, and then she says, "I know exactly who did this. It was Quark." So she's saying, "Yeah, it was Quark. He's always been after me, trying to get me, kicked off the promenade for competition and everything." She's yelling here again, "I'm telling you, it was him." And then Odo down here, as much as he's always been at odds with Quark, he says, "I don't trust Quark any farther than I can throw him, and I could throw him a great distance if you'd allow me to, Captain." Love that line. But this seems too violent and extreme for Quark, which, I would agree with. He's always, doing his petty schemes and stuff like that. Violence usually isn't the Ferengi way. So as soon as she said Quark, it makes a lot of sense that Quark would attack a rival business there on the station. But again, like Odo says here, it just seems just out of line for Quark. So they go to see Bashir, who's doing autopsies on everyone, and they find out that there are these things called rodinium darts, which are these like nasty little like shrapnel looking things that are banned in the Federation because they're just, because of their intent to kill, and just like one of those weapons of war that's banned because it's like almost like in the real world now we ban like chemical warfare because it's just too bad even for war. And so they're trying to figure out how they got them onto the station and everything like that. Now then, and right here, they float the idea that maybe it was Garak himself that blew up the station. So Dax asks how Garak is, and Bashir says he's fine, just a few bumps and scratches. He saved my life, he pulled me out of there. And Dax says, "You don't think he had anything to do with this, do you?" And Bashir says back, "I doubt it. After all, it was his idea for us to eat there, but with Garak, you never know." And this very true, with Garak, you do never, ever know. So then we have kind of a senior staff meeting here, and Sisko is telling them, like, "Look, we got to figure this out because we had some Nausicaans die, we had a Ferengi die, we had some Bajorans, I believe, injured as well." And he's going through here. He's like, "Look, I've got Nausicaa on the phone, I've got the Ferenginar on the phone, I've got to explain this to Admiral Ross. There's still a war going on. It's like, I need you guys to figure this out because my phone is ringing off the hook." I've said this a few times, it just feels like a great episode of Star Trek Deep Space Nine. More investigator notes here. He says, "No matter what sort of crime is committed, the first question that leads to the truth is always the same. Who benefits?" In a case like this, that's not going to be an easy question to answer. With the war going on, it would be easy to chalk this up to an act of terror, but no one has claimed responsibility, and it's hard to see how the Cardassians or the Dominion could claim much victory from the loss of a coffee shop. Quark is a criminal and an irritant, but he's hardly a murderer, even for profit. And while Garak is capable of anything, he's also a survivor. If he wanted that shop gone for whatever reason, he wouldn't have needed to place his own life at risk to do it, which leaves me for now precisely where I started. So he's back at square one. He's like, all of my regular suspects here, they all have good reasons to not be the suspect. Quark isn't one to use violence. Garak could have, if he wanted that shop gone, could have done it a different way. If it was a terrorist attack, no one's claimed responsibility. And if they were going to plant a bomb on the station, why bomb a coffee shop? Why not bomb something more vital to the station, like shields or the armory or the weapons cache or something like that? So going through those investigator motions, then good old Worf shows up, and he wants to throw the blame on the Nausicaans because they're just basically terrible people. And well, they're Nausicaans, and if you're a fan of Star Trek, you know how the Nausicaans are. And speaking of Nausicaans, some show up and basically try to shake Odo down, be like, "Why haven't you figured this out yet?" Almost start a fight with Worf there until Odo intervenes. They smash up his desk and walk away. I love it. Worf here says, I told you they were ill-tempered. And so then Odo gets a communique, and they've found something. They found more of those rodinium darts coming in on a new shipment that was addressed to none other than Quark. And you can see the look of shock on his face. So all in all, I don't think it was Quark. I think, you know, he's much more one for petty schemes and things like that. He's not going to bomb someone. I don't think he has kind of a violent bone in his body. We've seen plenty of episodes of Star Trek Deep Space Nine where he had to engage in violence and was very not good at it and even off-putting to him. So I don't think it's Quark. I think, did I say Garrick a minute ago? I'm sorry if I did. I don't think it's Quark. If it's, you know, it's just not in his nature. So we'll see where this one goes. We obviously have three more issues to see how this plays out, and I'll definitely be picking those up. So Cam, thank you for recommending this to me. And guys, if anyone out there has any recommendations for me, always drop those in the comments. I'm always looking for something new to read, something that I don't normally read, something to get me off my normal beaten path. I may not get to it immediately, but I'm always reading the comments and taking those into my mind. So if it may take me a while to get there, but I'll usually try and get there. So guys, what did you think about Star Trek Deep Space Nine, the Too Long a Sacrifice issue number one? Let me know your thoughts and opinions down in the comments down below. Thank you so much for watching. If it's your first time here at the channel, I almost said at the station, at the channel, go ahead and hit that subscribe button for me. It would mean a lot. And until next time, we'll see you at the comic shop.